Archdiocese of San Antonio and CTSA invite you to join us in celebrating these sacred mysteries, hearing God's Word, and partaking of spiritual communion. Welcome to the Daily Mass.
We are gathered this morning in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Boy, do we have a lot to celebrate today. First Saturday, Happy New Year. No, Happy New Year's Eve, because tomorrow or tonight at your vigil masses, we begin the new church year. And we're 39. Can you tell? Actually, CTSA is 39. I'm a little bit older than that. So to all the sponsors ahead of time, thank you. We'll say more at the end. As we come together at the end of a church year, as we look and we start to realize that Advent is upon us, we start that preparation process, we prepare for this celebration by calling to mind and asking forgiveness for our sins. Lord Jesus, you came to heal us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you came to give us hope. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are the way, the truth, and the light. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Stir up the will of your faithful, we pray, O Lord, that striving more eagerly to bring your divine work to fruitful completion, they may receive in greater measure the healing remedies your kindness bestows. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Revelation. John said, "An angel showed me the river of life giving water, sparkling like crystal, flowing from the throne of God and of the Lamb down the middle of the street. On either side of the river grew the tree of life that produces fruit 12 times a year, once each month. The leaves of the trees serve as medicine for all the nations. Nothing accursed will be found anymore. The throne of God and of the Lamb will be in it, and his servants will worship him. They will look upon his face, and his name will be on their foreheads. Night will be no more, nor will they need light from lamp or sun, for the Lord God shall give them light, and they shall reign forever and ever." And he said to me, "These words are trustworthy and true. And the Lord, the God of prophetic spirits, sent his angels to show his servants what must happen soon. Behold, I am coming soon. Blessed is the one who keeps the prophetic message of this book, the word of the Lord." Thanks be to God. Maranatha, come, Lord Jesus. Maranatha, come, Lord Jesus. Come, let us sing joyfully to the Lord. Let us acclaim the rock of our salvation. Let us come into his presence with thanksgiving. Let us joyfully sing psalms to him. Maranatha, come, Lord Jesus. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hands are the depths of the earth, and the tops of the mountains are his. His is the sea, for he has made it, and the dry land which his hands have formed. Maranatha, come, Lord Jesus. Come, let us bow down and worship. Let us kneel before the Lord, who made us. For he is our God, and we are the people. He shepherds, the flock he guides. Maranatha, come, Lord Jesus.
Be vigilant at all times and pray that you may have the strength to stand before the Son of Man. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Beware that your hearts do not become drowsy from carousing and drunkenness and the anxieties of daily life, and that day catch you by surprise like a trap. For that day will assault everyone who lives on the face of the earth. Be vigilant at all times and pray that you have the strength to escape the tribulations that are imminent and stand before the Son of Man." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Well, as you'd expect, after everything we've been through the last many weeks of the church year, the church is going to leave us with that point: are you prepared? And nicely, we have Advent, a season of preparation starting later today, that helps us with that. But what does it really mean to be prepared? How do we know that we're ready? Trick question. We don't. There's nothing we can do. And that was the problem the Pharisees and Sadducees fell into. They created these they had these 613 laws, and they decided if they just stuck in between the rails of those 613 laws, nothing else mattered. But then Jesus comes and says, nah, the fulfillment of all those and what the basis for all of them is to love your neighbor, to love the Lord your God with your whole heart, and to obviously love yourself. And that turns everything on end, because are we loving enough? Are we doing the things that we need to do? Even the gospel says it isn't going to be easy. So I tell people when they're having issues with family members or frenemies or whatever it is, that you have to pray for them and you have to love them. They don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear it. But it's that call each of us has to live in this world to love. And Jesus wouldn't have said it was going to be difficult if it wasn't going to be difficult. And I think as we enter into Advent, it's not a season of penance and of, like Lent is, but of preparation, but it comes down to the same things. We look at ourselves and we say, are we ready? And we can tell if we do this right at Christmas. Is it the same old Christmas we've had every other year? Well, we'll have a pandemic this year, that'll make it different. But that isn't the point. The point is, are we truly realizing that gift of being created in the image and likeness of God? And with that, we need to be a light, not just to the people we liked. And if we go through all the gospel stories of the Sadducees and Pharisees have been trying to trip Jesus up, and the scribes trying to trick him, he doesn't lash out at any of them, really. He challenges them. He calls them deeper into their faith. And anybody that comes to him, he embraces. Even people like Zacchaeus, who had led pretty despicable lives, he embraces them. He calls them into himself. So as we look and as we end this church year, I think it's a good time to do a reflection. Where has God been present throughout this last church year? Where have we wished that God was present, which realizing God was present, we just weren't aware of that? And what can we do to help our realization that God is with us always? And work day by day to make sure that more and more, as each day passes, we're aware of God's presence. And for me, one of the greatest tests of how I'm doing this is when I drive, because there are a lot of people that are very gifted at helping me realize my shortcomings in San Antonio. See, I put that in a positive way. And as we look at that, every time I look, I go to say something to some gift from God that cuts me off, slams on their brakes in front of me, makes a left turn in front of me, whatever it might be, I realize I'm not praying for that person. I hope to. Sometimes it takes one or two little events before I realize, hello, knucklehead, you need to pray for that person. They're probably in more of a hurry than you are. Pray for them. Or then maybe they're, whatever they have going on, they're distracted. And that's sort of my, one of my gauges, how I deal with things that go wrong at the church and the school. Am I putting it in the sense of where God is? Am I stopping for a moment and say, God, guide me in this? Am I constantly aware that I'm here as an agent of God? And that's where it's difficult. Because we celebrated last weekend the King of the Universe. Sometimes I think we like to think we're the King of the Universe. We want to think we have everything put together. We're in total control. We have this covered. And when we do that, we miss. So our challenge, I think, especially as we transition from one year to the next, is to take a healthy look. Where have we done well? Where could we do better? And what plans can we put in place to make sure that God is more a part of everything we do for our entire day as we work at being true stewards of this creation which God has given us? With trust and confidence, we turn to our loving Father and ask with our needs. We turn to our loving Father with each of our needs.
For the church, as the mystical body of Christ, may she grow and prosper in the Lord's saving work. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all nations and peoples torn by strife, may the Lord grant them his peace. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For those subject to harsh living conditions in this upcoming winter season, may God provide for them and bless them with loving and compassionate neighbors. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For an increase in vocations in the church, may the church continue to be led by those who are dedicated to the mission of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For those in our community who face a difficult holiday season from the loss of a loved one, may the Lord bring them strength in the presence of family and friends. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For those who have died this liturgical year, may they find eternal rest in the arms of Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Merciful Father, we pray that as you answer each of these prayers in your gracious mercy, that we have the courage to hear the answer. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this bread we offer you, food of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this wine we offer you, food of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours
may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the all of his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, the sacred offerings which at your bidding we dedicate to your name, and in order that through these gifts we may become worthy of your love, grant us unfailing obedience to your commands. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ your Son, who is our Lord. His death we celebrate in love, his resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so, with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by that same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension to heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the offering of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, St. Anthony of Padua, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant, Francis, our Pope, and Gustavo, our Archbishop, Mike, his auxiliary, the order of bishops, the clergy, religious, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned here before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, Gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. And to our departed brothers and sisters, I'd like to remember especially this morning, all those priests that in this last year, especially Monsignor Terry Nolan, who have died, and all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom we bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we now dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us so offer to one another as appropriate a sign of Christ's peace. 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 Let's pray for peace for our world. Lamb of God, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe all that you are in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though you were already here, I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. We pray, Almighty God, that those to whom you give the joy of participating in divine mysteries may never be parted from you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So I probably should not be the one to do this, but at 39 years, the people, you have to give huge kudos to Archbishop Flores, who saw this vision and that need. I think long before many other people saw that need to have an ability for the Catholic Church to reach out. And although television now is very different than it was back then, because we watch it on our phones, there's the internet, there's all those other social media outlets that are part of this root idea with Monsignor Steuben and all those other people that worked. And then I remember the fight. I was not a priest of this diocese yet, but I remember watching and wishing that where I was we could do something similar to keep it on the basic cable plan. I remember how long, that was quite a while ago, but that fight so it could stay on the basic cable so that church would not be something more people had to pay for. And if you look at the program, I was just looking at the intro to this, they're starting this a little bit differently now, and it's nice. I mean, it's not just the other places I have been, it's church, obviously church, but a lot of work has gone into this. So to all the staff, to all the people that have made this happen, to all the amazing sponsors, I won't pick out the one that's helping out Catholic schools right now, but to all the sponsors for CTSA, thank you. It makes a difference. As one of the priests that helps out with it, I don't go very many places that somebody says, and it's sort of shocking, oh, I've seen you on TV, and I'm thinking, no, you didn't. Then I realize, oh yeah, I sort of am on TV. Sorry. It's just my brain how it works. And people are constantly there, hey, thank you for that. So the sponsors that continue to make this possible, thank you. In our current world, it's even more necessary. And I don't think it's any cheaper. The fact, all the technology that seems to be making it easier, that technology is not cheap. So, because I just put all the live streaming stuff in my church, I know. So to all the sponsors that make this possible, thank you. To the staff at CTSA that I know is woefully underpaid, but does just such an amazing job. We're up for what? You're all up for what, three Emmys, four Emmys this year? Three Emmys this year. That's amazing. So, to all the sponsors, everybody, thank you. I have no idea where we are time-wise, but the prayer? No. Let's do the prayer for the pandemic, because we need this thing to be over. I don't know about you all, but I'm done with the pandemic. I pray every day for the end, but let's do it at the end of Mass today also. Our Lady of Guadalupe, in these times of tribulation, we turn to you, O Mother. See with compassion the suffering of your beloved sons and daughters, affected by the coronavirus pandemic throughout the entire world. Ask your Son to have mercy on us, bringing healing to those infected, strength to those in recovery, and protection to all your children. Jesus Christ, Savior of all people, grant us courage to accompany the care for the entire world in the wake of sorrow and uncertainty. We seek refuge in you, according to your promise. Deliver us from this danger. Amen. St. Anthony of Padua, pray for us. Hope you guys didn't eat too much at Thanksgiving, and happy end of what has been a truly unique church year. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, proclaiming the good news with your lives.
Amen.